the power of the Lord was present for him to heal the sick. Some men came carrying a paralytic on a mat and tried to take him into the house to lay him before Jesus. When they could not find a way to do this because of the cloud, they went up on the roof and lowered him on his mat through the tiles into the middle of the cloud, right in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." The Pharisees and the teachers of the law began to think to themselves, "Who is this fellow? Who is this fellow who speaks blasphemy? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" Jesus knew what they were thinking and asked, "Why are you thinking these things in your hearts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, walk,' but that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins?" He said to the paralytic man, "I tell you, get up, take your mat, and go home." Immediately, he stood up in front of them and took what he had been lying on and went home praising God. Everyone was amazed and gave praise to God. They were filled with awe and said, "We have seen remarkable things today." Every day, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, today the day come today, let our eyes see and remarkable things in our life. Let our ears hear and remarkable things in our life. Let my listener hear and remarkable things in his life. I thank you for this moment. Speak to us through me. In Jesus' name I pray. Mm-hmm. I have said today I want to talk about a friend who is very different from the crowd. The Bible says when Jesus was seated and he was teaching various classes of people, those who are learning, Pharisees, Sadducees, those who knew the law, the lawyers, they were seated and the house was full to the capacity. People had known from the villages of Galilee and Judea that Jesus is teaching in the temple. And that's why they swung to the temple that day to receive the teachings of God. Church, I want to say, it is only in the church where we can receive the true teachings of God. The Bible says, while Jesus was teaching and people were listening to him, there were some people somewhere who were doing another work to help a certain man who was sick for a long time. The Bible says this man was paralytic. He has been there for all that long. People knew him. I know he had parents, he had brothers. But none of them took care of him. The Bible says in this specific time that there were men, hallelujah, mm-hmm, I want to be associated with men who can be care, who can take care of me, not the crowd, not my relative, not my boss, not the leaders, not the priests. There were priests by the time. ilikuwa ilikuwa imejaa maana watu walikuwa wanajua Yesu alikuwa anakuja kwao. You know, it is only when we know, it is only where Jesus is there is salvation. I am saying, we shall be saved when we shall come back to our senses and know it is only where Jesus is there is salvation.
Amen.
I am speaking to the Kenyans today. It is only when we come back to our senses and know it is only where Jesus is there is solution politically, economically, and even in our health, in our homes, in our family status. The problem that are facing our families, and it's mentioned this time, it is my prayer that God will make you understand it is only in the Lord Jesus you find the solution of your family.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. There were people who knew, and everybody knew, even the town knew, it is only in Jesus. And that's why even the teachers of the law went to reason to Jesus. The Bible says, where Jesus was and where Jesus is, there is power to heal.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said there is power to heal.
Amen.
Where Jesus is, all what is required of us is to realize and recognize where Jesus is. We go there and there we will be leading for our family, our country, our political team will be healed there. Praise the Lord Jesus. There is a lot of confusion in the political arenas. But if people know where the solution is, they must learn to where Jesus is. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Everybody knew that Jesus is in town. Teachers of the law, the Sadducees, the priests of the time, they say, no, enough is enough, let us go and listen to this man. He may change our attitude of thinking. He may open our eyes. The Bible says, while Jesus was teaching in the synagogue, there were men, according to my concordance, the Bible says there were five men. They were preparing this man who was paralytic for many years. The Bible says this man was in his mat for all his life. And here comes this man who said, no, we have realized there is Jesus is in the temple. We better take this man to Jesus. Wazazi wake walikuwa hawakumshughulikia. Watu wakwao wa nyumba yao wale walitanishwa hawakumshughulikia. Wengine waliweza tu kumpeleka, waliweza kumpelekea maji ya kulalia, wengine waliweza kumpelekea sukari. Lakini Biblia inasema kulikuwa na hawa waliojitoa, akasema afadhali tusisikie injili, afadhali tusisikie mafundisho, lakini sisi tupeleke huyu mtu hata asisikie injili lakini apate uponyaji. Haleluya. Oh, praise the Lord. There is what man can do to you and there is what God can do to you. This man, their responsibility was to prepare this man, carry him in his mat, take him to Jesus. That was their responsibility. Hallelujah. Kuna wakati imani ya watu wengine itakuponya. Kuna wakati imani yako itakuponya. Hallelujah. Kuna wakati, na unisikize vizuri, kuna wakati imani yako haitafanya kazi, imani ya watu wengine itafanya kazi kwa niaba yako.
Amen.
That's why I'm saying you better have a good relationship with other men.
Hallelujah.
And that's why today that your healing is not automatic. There are many hindrances. Your blessings, your miracle. You know, people these days, they are rushing. They are learning from miracles. Not necessarily that your miracle will come automatic. No! There will be many obstacles if you are a true man of God.
Yeah.
There are hindrances. People have taken a chance to take this man to Jesus. But still there are some hindrances. Kulikuwa na vikwazo vya umati. Hallelujah. Aye, praise the Lord. Inasema hao watu walikuwa wameamua. Na sasa karibu wafungike moyo. We have done all what we have done, but now we cannot accept Jesus where he is. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu ya umati. Maana pia umati unataka kumuona Yesu. Na wewe pia, hata kana kwamba hujui kinachoendelea. There are some people who are taking care of you. They want Jesus not only to see him, but they want this man to be healed.
Amen.
Imani ya mtu mwingine. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hey, hallelujah.
Amen.
From today, I will never blame those who are nasemanga. Na wende ukiniombea. Najuaga wanajuaga imani yao imefika mwisho. Ukisikia mtu anaitisha maombi. Ana imani. Sasa amesema imani ya watu wengine ifanye nini? Na si vibaya. Sema amina.
Amina.
Yes. Ukiona mtu anasemanga sasa do this on my behalf. Anajua ameshindwa. That's why watu watano waliamua kushika huyu mtu na wampeleke mahali Yesu alikuwa. Maana Biblia inasema na nguvu za uponyaji zilikuwa dhahiri. They were present. The power of healing was present at that time. It is not a school church, no. Whenever we go to God, we are assured that the power of healing, the power of intervention is present. They knew. These people knew that the power of healing was present. But you know what? We are not told in the whole service that there were other people who were healed. But we are told of this specific man who was taken there by other people's faith, not his own faith. There were some people who had gone there with their faith, but their faith had down. But this specific man, the Bible says, we are not told of other people who are healed, but actually, this time, it is only this man, paralytic man who was healed. Praise the Lord, church.
Amen.
Hey, kanisa, bana sifiwe. Ningependa kusema hivi kwa ibada hii ya pili. Siku ya leo, ni vizuri Mungu akaweza kutusaidia, tukaweza kuwa na wale watu ambao wanaweza kushika na kubeba mizigo yetu. Tusiwe na wale watu ambao, they do not even care about us. Wakambeba huyu mtu na wakaenda naye wakakuta nyumba imejaa, hawana mahali pa kuingilia. Umati umefunga mlango. Milango yote ilikuwa imefungwa. So they say no. Hatuwezi tukapoteza huu wakati. Msiwe kama wana wa Israeli in the book of Numbers 21. The Bible says walitembea na wakavunjika moyo, wakaanza kulalamikia Mungu. Do you know unaweza kuwa umevunjika moyo? Maana umefika milango imekufungwa. Maana umefika. Ibada zetu sasa hivi karibuni tumekuwa tukifungia watu nje. Wale wamefika. Maana tuko tunataka kuvunja sheria ya nchi. Ukija tunafunga hivi. Vivyo vile ilivyokuwa na wakati wa huyu mtu, walikuta milango imefungwa, watu wamejaa, they had no access to the altar. They needed somebody. They needed another extra thinking. Oh, hallelujah. Ni vyema ukaweze kujiunganisha na watu wanaotumia kizwa vizuri. Ujiunganisha na watu ambao wako na good connection ya mbinguni. Ambao hawatumii mlango peke yake. You know there are some people who think that you can be able to go through Jesus. Through so and so, through this and this. Kama umejaribu mbegu imeshindwa, tafuta njia nyingine. Unajua kuna watu wanafikirianga. Na unajua kanisa na siku hizi. Ufikirianga Mungu anahitaji mbegu kuliko vitu vingine vyote. Uwezi ukaomba Mungu. Unajua kuna watu wamefikiria, nikitoa hii mbegu, Mungu ataingilia mambo yangu. Utajaribu hiyo utakuta kumefungwa. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are some people who are very good givers, but actually, they have not accessed the presence of God.
Oh, yes.
May God help us this afternoon. closed and the other door is closed, can we use another method to access where Jesus is?
Amen.
Amen. One of us who are talking about, I don't blame them. I don't blame them. Wakiona hili lango limefungwa na hili lingine limefungwa, wanatafuta njia nyingine ya kuaccess Jesus. Those people are not bad. They are just trying to access Jesus in another, through another door. Can you say a good amen?
Amen.
I am here to advise you, brethren, that we need to look for another way to access our God, to access our healing. Because it is there. The power of healing is always there to them that are available. It is always there to those who are available, not those who are far away. And these men say, no, we cannot have wasted our time, our resources, our strength, coming here in faith. We must see Jesus, and this man must have a contact with God. He said, no. And they decided to go to the roof. They removed the tiles and they brought this man down through the roof to exactly where Jesus was. Hey, hapo ndio ufunuo huko. Hawakuingizia huyu mtu mahali popote, walijua Mungu ako kwa madhabahu. Hawakumuingilia kwa mahali popote, walitoa tiles and the presence mahali Yesu alikuwa. Na walipomteremsha, sikiza ujumbe na ushuhuda wa Yesu anasema nini. Alisema imani yenu, si imani ya huyu mtu,
imani yenu,
imani ya huyu hawa watu. So you need to have good relationship with men who are men of faith. Unajua kwa wale watu unatembeana nao huwa wanamaanisha sana kwa maisha yako. Kama si watu wa imani utakaa vile. Kama ni watu wa imani watasimama kwa niaba yako. They can even die on your behalf. Hawajali vile itakavyotokea kwa mwenye nyumba. Hawajali vile itakavyotokelezea kwa wao kwa sababu ya the leadership of the synagogue. Alisema sisi tutateremsha. May God help us, church, this morning that we should know that we should be associated with people of faith. Watu wa imani. Ambao wanaweza kubeba mizigo yetu kwa niaba yetu. Ambao wanaweza kutupeleka mahali hatuwezi kujipeleka. Haleluya. Huyu mtu Biblia inasema alikuwa amelemea, amelemaa. Kwa hivyo angeweza kujipeleka. You need, you are your brother's keeper. Don't be like Cain, who said, I am not my brother's keeper. Kuna watu wa Kristo siku hizi wamekuwa na roho ya Kaini ya kusema, mimi sio ninayeweka ndugu yangu. Today I came to say, you need your brother, you need your sister. For you to accept,
yes,
what you have been missing all your life.
Yes.
Whether the doors are closed, whether there is no access to your miracle, there are some people who are going to work on your behalf. Kisha inasema, wakamteremsha. Na walipomteremsha, wakamwangusha mbele ya Yesu. Walipomwangusha mbele ya Yesu, wakasema, no, hii imani ya watu ni kubwa, sijawahi iona. Na ukisikia Yesu anasema hiyo imani haikuwa imani kidogo, ilikuwa ni imani. Kosa kile pia alizangaa. Hao watu hawangeweza kupitia kwa malango, kwa madirisha. Hao watu wametumia imani yao ni kubwa. Akaambia aliyekuwa amelema, umesamewa dhambi. That was the first stage. You know, many people, they want to receive miracle even before they are forgiven their sins. Mm. It is a process. Mm. It is a process.
Yeah.
If you are looking for a miracle and you are a sinner, I'm telling you, it is not applicable. First, your sins must be forgiven.
Yeah.
The procedure,
yeah,
the process of God, he said, your sins are forgiven. What wakaza pralamika sema uli nani anaye, sami ya tapi. Pengine, listen to me, church. I am convinced in my heart, this man was paralytic because of his sins. Huyu mtu haisi kuhitaji nabii kumwambia kama Mungu alimwambia, ume sin yet. Your sins are forgiven. Sin no more. They have not sin no. So that many mighty and great things may happen unto you. Asubia leo. Tunapojiandaa kwenda nyumbani. Ni ombi langu ni kuulize unaenda kujiunganisha na nani? Who is your business partner? Unajua kwa wale watu unajihusisha nao. Kama unajihusisha na wasawi utakuwa mchawi bila kupenda. Kama wewe ni maraya na kama wewe si maraya na unaendanga na maraya, actually whether you try to wash yourself, people will call you maraya.
Yeah.
Who is your companion? Wale watu wa mdomo. Pere pere pere. Ukienda na wao utakuwa pia na wewe. Huyo mtu achana naye, hiyo mtu kwa alabalabas. May God help us. Huyo mtu alikuwa amejiunganisha na watu ambao walimshughulikia wakati wa mahitaji ya muhimu. Yesu akasema sijawahi ona imani kama hii. Watu walipolalamika akasema, ni lipi gumu kwangu kusema umesamehe ama umeponywa? You know the complaint of your opponent will make you to receive the next miracle. Say amen.
Amen.
You know, if at all these people didn't complain, this man would have remained paralytic. But because they complain, please do not hate your enemies. Because actually these people, the teachers of the law and the priests, the Sadducees and the Pharisees, they say, no, who is this man? He's a prisoner. He is insulting God. Nobody can forgive sins. Say, no, forgiving is not even harder than healing people. What is harder? I say, no, my brother, I forgive your sin, but now receive healing, take your mat, and go home.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why was he told to go home? This is what the revelation is as I conclude. He was told, take your mother and go what? Maana kama angeenda vijijini na visorozoroni angeambiwa mambo mengine ambayo ingeshusha roho yake. Kuna watu siku hizi na nyakati hizi za corona COVID-19. Mungu amewaficha katika nyumba ili wasichafuke roho. Pengine umekuwa umesikia mengi. Kuna mambo Mungu amezuia usiyasikie. Alipoponya huyu mtu alimwambia, chukua gondoro lako na uende wapi? After this, and especially to those who are watching me through the YouTube, please don't engage yourself with many things. If you don't have anything to do, hata watu wa ministry of health walisema, kaa nyumba. Hata walisema fanya nini? Sio mimi nimesema, walisema kaa wapi? Ati walisema nini? Ati walisema nini hapo nisikie?
Kaa nyumbani.
Kwani unadu? Si ukae nyumbani, usikize vile Roho anavyosema. Pengine Mungu hujawahi kaa nyumbani, ujue watoto wako the behavior of your children. Kaa nyu. Hallelujah. He was told, take your mother and go. Hapo aende kuongeza. Unajua huyu mtu paralytic pengine amekuwa akikaa barabarani akiombaomba. Saidia, saidia, saidia. But this time was told, no, please. Usiende kusaidiwa, umesaidika. Go. Go and have fellowship with your family. Go and tell them what God has done unto you. There are some people who will testify after this COVID-19. Ikiisha watasema, actually, I have seen God do this. So huyo mtu alipoponywa na watu walikuwa wakimjua, watu wote wakastaajabu na wakashangaa. And this was their confession. This was their confession. Na ndio nataka iwe confession yetu today. They were filled with awe and said, we have seen remarkable things today. Do you know what it means to say remarkable things? Something that's a mark that cannot be removed by people. You know, this is an remarkable. May God give you an remarkable things in your life.
Amen.
May God give you an remarkable things in your faith.
Amen.
May God give you an remarkable things in your business.
Amen.
You know, that's remarkable things. Christ is done. And they said, no, we have never seen. Today we have seen. Thank God, if you have eyes to see. To see the remarkable things that the Lord is doing into your life. And to your family. And to your business. And to your career. May your eyes see a remarkable thing today.
Amen.
We are not just here today as a routine. We are here to see a remarkable things in our life.
Amen.
If you came to today's service just for formality, I pity you. But if you came today and you have seen a remarkable thing today, may God bless you. Go home with a testimony today. Remarkable thing. Forget what I said. Not all eyes. Not all eyes sees. Eyes can look, but fail to see. If today you have seen a remarkable thing, thank God. Tusimame. Tusimame. Yes. Nataka tuombe hombi hili. Nataka mimi na wewe tuombe hombi hili. Before we go home. Mwambie Mungu ninataka kuona jambo ambalo nataka this remarkable thing. Nataka kuona remarkable thing. As I go home. Pengine kuna situation uliaza nyumbani ambayo haieleweki. Kwa siasa za Kenya, we want to see a remarkable thing from today. People are confused. But from today, we are going to see a remarkable thing. Can we raise up our hands and pray? Just open up your mouth. Open up your mouth and tell God that you want to see a remarkable thing. Mwambie Mungu mnataka kuona jambo mbaya.